Hello students, dear kids, in my previous class I have explained you a lesson, that is Sammy's friend. So let us recollect the story what you have learnt in the previous class. I will be telling you a lesson, this lesson in a short, okay. In that previous lesson there was a boy called Sammy and he was very happy and excited in his school. That day he had a sports activities in his school. After the sports activity, all the children rushed to have their lunch since they were tired and they were very much hungry. Same way Sammy also was very hungry, but he was sitting alone in a corner because he had forgot to bring his lunch bag. So he was sitting sad and he was thinking what to eat. That time one of his friend named Maya, she noticed that Sammy was sitting alone and he was looking sad. So she went to Sammy and asked, "What happened, Sammy? Why are you not eating your food?" Then Sammy replied sadly. He told that my mama had packed the tiffin bag, lunch bag, but I forgot to bring it to school. So I don't have anything to eat. So Maya, she got an idea. Then she loudly told all his friends that, "See friends, Sammy is not having anything to eat. So he has forgot his lunch bag. So what shall we do?" So one by one his friends came forward to share the food that day. So some of his friends told him, "You have whatever we are having the lunch, you can share it and we all together will eat." When all the friends shared the food, Sammy was having lot of things to eat, lot of food to eat. So he was very happy with that day, that type of friends, and he wished that everyone should have friends like him. So this was the story about Sammy's friend. Now before going to the poem, I will tell you few things. After this lesson we have some of the textual exercise children. So first I will be teaching you the poem, a new poem. After that again I will be telling you about the textual exercise, how to solve, and I will be writing only few answers. Remaining you have to try by yourself. If you try doing this exercise, your language will be improved and you can have the habit of solving all the questions by yourself. Till now I have given you the answers. From next lesson onwards, I will not be giving the answers. You have to find out the answers. And about the Sammy's friend also, I will be giving you some of the questions. You have to read the textbook, read the lesson, and bit by bit you have to answer the questions whatever I have asked you. It may be one word answer or it may be one sentence. So children, you have to think and write. Many of you, you don't read the heading. The heading will be answer in a word, but you'll be answering in a sentence. So always remember that whatever the heading is asked, you have to answer up to the mark. No need of answering too much or too less, because sometimes we ask you answer in a word, you write a long sentence and answer that question. So children, always remember, you have to read the heading. If whatever the heading is asked, you have to answer according to that one. So don't make the mistake. And sometimes we will be giving you extra in the notes, but you write that full whatever we have given in the notes, that full as it is answer you are copying there. In the test also I have observed it. What is a sentence is given, but what you people have done? What is a sentence? You have given the examples also. So understand the question first. It is asked only what is a sentence? Write only what is a sentence. If it is asked what is a sentence, give some examples. That time you have to write the examples. So don't repeat such kind of mistakes. Okay. So before doing the textual exercise, I'll be reading you a small poem. It is a very small poem. It is of only 8 lines. So we'll read and recite it. Okay, children. Open your textbook, children. Children, open textbook page number 37. The poem is on page number 37. Poem number 4 it is. Till now you have finished poem number 3. 1, 2 and 3. This is poem number 4. The name of the poem is, that is titled Heaven on Earth. Heaven on Earth. You all opened the textbook, children? Okay, let us read, okay? Little drops of water, little grains of sand, make the mighty ocean and the pleasant land. See, once again I'll be reading, children. You just observe the pronunciation, okay? Little drops of water, little grains of sand, make the mighty ocean and the pleasant land. So it is a very small poem. Here the poet is using the words to describe the earth. He is using the word drops of water, grains of sand. And he is using that it when we tell that grains of sand, it makes a mighty ocean and the land is pleasant. So the poet has written a very beautiful poem and it is very small. You can read it. This is first stanza, children. One more stanza is there. I'll be telling you that second one. The second stanza is little words of love and little deeds of kindness. Make the earth an Eden like the heaven above. See, children, the poet is using a very beautiful words. See, when we are living on this earth, if our words are of love and deeds of kindness, so we have to do the deeds with the kindness. If you have these qualities, that is love and kindness, the earth is like what? An Eden. Eden is a garden where it is a garden God had created it. So the poet is using a very beautiful words, little words of love. So words should be of love and little deeds of kindness. Our deeds should be of kindness. When these two we follow, then it makes the earth an Eden. And that Eden is like the heaven above. So where is Eden? Eden is above. Heaven above. So once again I'll read it. Listen carefully. Little words of love and little deeds of kindness make the earth an Eden like the heaven above. So once we will recite, children, this poem. So keep your finger on the textbook. So look at the words when we are reading and we move the fingers when you are reading. You can keep your index finger. You have to place your index finger on the words where you are reading. And when you are reading, you have to read it loudly. Okay. Shall we start it? Poem number 4. Heaven on Earth. It is on page number 37. So let us read. You have to recite it afterwards. little drops of water, little grains of sand. Make the mighty ocean and the pleasant land. Little words of love and little deeds of kindness. Make the earth an Eden like the heaven above. So children, you have to practice to recite the poem. All of a sudden you cannot learn it. So every day you need to repeat this poem at least twice. As you are roaming, sitting, standing, no, you just keep on reciting the poem. It is a very small poem of 8 lines. It's easy also. You can recite it. This is for recitation. So anytime I may call you and I may ask you to tell the poem. So you have to be ready. I may ask you some of the questions also. You need to answer those questions. So next will be my call will be of questions. I'll be calling you people to ask some of the questions or poem. So I may ask you to recite any poem, that is first, second, third or fourth. So be ready children, okay? So learn all the poems. So children, after this poem, turn your textbook to page number 33. Page number 33. Yes. Did you turn the pages? Are you ready? Okay. If you are ready, I'll be starting the textual exercise. So let us go for the textual exercise. First bit is, number these events in the correct order as they occur in the story. The first heading is, number these events in the correct order as they occur in the story. So in this exercise, they have given you few sentences. What was happening with the Samir? In that story, the sentences belong to that story. So it is jumbled. So you have to give the correct numbers as it has occurred in the story. So first sentence is, Maya felt very bad for poor Samir. So after that sentence, they have given you bracket children. Children, as I am telling you the answer, take pencil, be ready. I'll be telling you the answer. You can note down the answers. One or two I'll be telling. Remaining things you have to do by yourself. So, the second sentence is, it was the time for lunch. So, first sentence was, Maya felt very bad for poor Samir. Second sentence is, it was the time for lunch. Then, all the children shared their food with Samir. Samir had forgotten to bring his lunch. So, which is the first one? You have to put the numbers in the bracket. After each sentence, they have given you the bracket, right? So, first one will be, it was the time for lunch break. That is second one. So, this is the first sentence which has occurred in the story. Second one is, Samir had forgotten to bring his lunch. So that is second one. So still two are remain. That two you have to do by yourself. So you learn how to solve the textual bits. So next is, answer the questions. So this will be a little bigger answer. You try to write these answers in your rough notebook, not CW book. Which book? Rough notebook. Who was the first to notice Samir sitting in the corner? So, one of his friend has noticed Samir sitting alone. Who was that? Yes, it was Maya. So, write, Maya noticed Samir sitting alone in the corner. So, you have to answer this in a full sentence, children. So first one I have told you, remaining two you'll do by yourself. Why did not Samir bring his lunch box? Third one is, how did Samir thank his friends? So these two questions you should write by yourself. Then we'll go for the next one. Third one, choose the appropriate describing word from the box to fill in the blanks. Look at the example. So there it is given a yellow color box. In that box, some words are there. So what is the heading telling us? Describing words. So what are these describing words? I have taught you in my grammar class. Do you remember, children? Yes. I hope you all remember the parts of speech. There are 8 parts of speech. And in that, one speech, part of speech will tell us about the word which will describe the noun or the pronoun. Which is that? Yes, it is an adjective. The definition of adjective is, an adjective is a word that describes or tells something more about a noun. So, describing words means you have to fill the correct adjectives in the blank. One is done. Example, a cheerful sound. Example is a cheerful sound. So, in the box they have given you faithful, cheerful, tasty, delicious, old, sad, sunny, happy. So these are the words which are describing the things, that is noun. So what are the words, correct words you have to write in the blank. First one I'll tell you, a dash day. So what is the word we use to describe the day? So it is a sunny day. Sunny day. A dash friend. A dash friend. So how are the friends? They are faithful. A faithful friend. A faithful friend. So children, remaining you try to do by yourself. If possible, I'll be correcting in my next videos. I'll be telling you the answers, or I may give you through PDF these answers. So let us see how it is possible for me to give the answer. Shall we go for the next bit? The next bit is, in each set of words, there is a word which is the general name of all the other in it. So there are the group of words in this bit. So that group of word is containing one general name. So you have to underline that word. One is done for you. What is that? Student, teacher, class, bench. So the general word is class. So student belongs to class, teacher belongs to class, bench belongs to class. So this is, class is a general word for this group. Second one is breakfast, lunch, dinner, food. Breakfast, lunch, dinner, food. So in this group of words, which is the general word name? Yes, food is the general name. So you have to underline for that food. Already food is given there, children. I am writing here only food and underline. So you underline the food. So remaining, it's your work. Try to do it and gain the knowledge. We'll go to the next bit, that is fifth one bit. Fill in the blanks with the correct form of the words given in the bracket. Fill in the blanks with the correct form of the words given in bracket. So, fill in the blanks are given, children. After the fill in the blanks, there is one word. It is given in the bracket. So, we have to think and write it. So, I'll be reading, you see. Maya dash Samir sitting alone. Maya dash Samir sitting alone. So, the word in the bracket is given notice. What? Notice. So, you have to write this answer in the correct form. So, here word is given notice. Notice is not a correct form there because it should be in a past tense form. Notice is present. Notice is past tense. So, you have to fill the blanks with the past tense form. You have to fill in the blanks with the past tense form. Maya noticed Samir sitting alone. What is the blank answer? Noticed. Second one, Samir dash say I dash Samir's, sorry, to bring my lunch box. Samir dash I dash to bring my lunch box. The words in the bracket are, first one is say. Samir dash say. So, past tense of say is, past tense of say, that is said. Samir said. Past tense of say is said. Samir said, I forgot to bring my lunch box. Forget, past tense is forgot. So, the blank should be Samir said, I forgot to bring my lunch box. So, same way, third, fourth and fifth you have to write by yourself. So, children, you will gain the knowledge of past tense here. Present tense and past tense. I have already explained you few present tense, past tense in my previous classes. So, you have to think and write the correct form of answer to fill in the blanks. So, shall we go for the next one? The next bit is sixth one. So, next bit is sixth bit, that is on page number 35. Page number 35. Look at the picture given below. They are almost same. So, you can see in that page, there are two pictures given. So, the two pictures are almost same. The picture is containing the same things, but few things are missing in picture B. So, here they have given the pictures. You can label it as picture A, picture B. So, what is missing? In picture B, some things are missing. Write 5 sentences about picture B in the space provided. See the sample. So, one is done. Both the pictures you can see. Observe the pictures, children. In that pictures, picture A is having the few things and in picture B, those things are missing in picture B. So, you have to observe it keenly. So, this is finding the difference between the pictures. Finding the difference. I hope that you all have played this game in the online games. So, you have to find the same difference here. So, how many difference you have to find? 6 difference. One is done. A girl is missing. You can see in picture A, a girl is there. Whereas in picture B, that girl is not there. So, a girl is missing. One more I'll tell you. You can see the clock on the wall. In picture B, the clock is missing. In picture A, clock is there. So, you can write, a clock is missing. So, again, few things are there. Some calendar is there, book is there. You just observe, children, wherever the things are missing, just write in the place provided there. Small place is provided, space is provided. You have to write your answer in that space. So, till now, I have done the exercise. You have copied or no, I don't know. But next onwards, you will learn how to solve the textual bits. So, try doing all this exercise, whatever I am telling, okay? So, then we'll go for the next bit. That is, write the names of Samir's friend. So, you have to read the textbook, read the lesson. Who were Samir's friend? You mention the names of those friends in the space provided. One is done. That is Maya. After Maya, there are dash, 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 dash. So, you can read the lesson and write the friend's name. Who all were Samir's friend? You write the names of his friends. Then the next bit is, that is jumbled letters. So, in this bit, jumbled letters are given below. So, each number, each letter, word is having the letters jumbled. It is mixed up. It is wrong spelling. So, you have to put them in the right way. Who should do? You have to put them in a right way to make meaningful words. All words begins with letter S. See, observe, children. So, there are letter group of letters. So, these letters are jumbled and it will make a meaningful word if you put them in a correct word. So, and one more thing is, all the words will start with S. That is, it begins with S. First one is H-O-S-U-T. H-O-S-U-T. The word is, did you get it? Did you try it, children? Yes. Try. Let me see. I'll give you a few seconds. You can try the word. After that, I'll be telling you the answer. Try to write. First letter is S. It begins with S. Okay. I think so. You all tried it but couldn't get it because you all are very busy in this lockdown, enjoying TV, mobiles, not looking into the textbook, not reading the words. All this you all are doing, no? So you may not get the answer. If you have got it, it is well and good, and you are very good children. Yes, the word is shout. What is the word? Shout. S-H-O-U-T. S-H-O-U-T. Copy, children. Once again I repeat. S-H-O-U-T. Second one. Yes. T-S-R-T-A. T-S-R-T-A. So, this also word will start with S. S-T-A-R-T. Start. What is the word? S-T-A-R-T. I repeat once again. Copy, children. S-T-A-R-T. So, remaining words you have to do by yourself. Three more are there. Try to do it. If you are not able to do, I will be telling you the answers. So at least you try to do by yourself. Okay children, till 35 page number I have finished. So children, I hope you all understood what I have told you. So recite the poem, solve all the textual exercise and take your help. If you want, you can take your parents' help, but don't allow your parents to write. Write by yourself. First try to do by yourself. If it is not possible, you can take your parents' help to answer it, not to write. So complete these all the textual bits children, because you have to practice all this. We may ask you in the test some of the textual bits to answer. And I told you to recite the poem. I have taught you a new poem, that is Heaven on Earth. So practice memorizing that poem. So memorize that poem, solve the textual bits and read for the coming test. So take care children. Thank you.